Yeah, well, what I realized was there was no problems with my calculations or the data that Agnes accessed or the inducer itself. What I was forced to admit, the problem was with me.
Now there's a surprise.
You, Gordo? Whatever do you mean?
He means that he can't carry a tune in a bucket.
I don't understand.
Well, I'm afraid Grandpa Hank is right. My improvised vocalizations, I don't even know how to say it.
You sounded like an alley cat in a dog pound.
I kind of did. Remember this, though. The solution to our problem stands right before us. It's Kit.
What?
Yeah, Kit, you're the solution to the problem. You have the most perfect voice. It's going to be perfect. We've got to get ready for test run beta. Come on.
Howdy, folks. How y'all doing?
Let me tell you a story about Skinny T. A young country boy just as nice as he could be. His tractor started smoking and it almost threw a rod when he reached in his jaw and he fixed it with a wad of chewing gum, that is. Spearmint. Sugar-free. Well, the next thing you know, young Skinny T's the boy that everybody knew could fix a broken car or toy. NASCAR asked his paw if they could have an interview to sign him up and make him their first one. What did crew? Race car crew, that is. Motor oil. Checkered flags. But Skinny T is just too young to start on his career. He's only 10 and still has got to go to school this year. He might even go to college for an engineer degree. Auto racing still will be there. They'll just have to wait and see. There ain't no hurry. You're still a boy. Take time to go fishing, you hear?
Well, Skinny T, it's a pleasure to see you. Come on up and do a little fishing. Nice to have a kid around here who's halfway sane. Now, these are over here trying to conjure up a Jubilee with their gizmo, and I am trying to catch old General Washington.
The General, Grandpa? Nobody can catch the General. There ain't many folks ever even claim they've seen him.
Well, now, just because he ain't been caught don't mean he can't be caught. And I've seen him. I've seen him with my own two eyes. Why, that monster was old. He had to be...
Oh, that's a big fish, Grandpa Hank.
Big? He's a lot bigger than this. I'm saying he was this far from my daddy's boat. When I catch that monster, I'm going to teach him a lesson he won't never forget. God gave dominion over this earth, and he didn't give it to no fish the way my Bible reads it.
Well, I guess if anybody's going to catch that fish, Grandpa Hank, it ought to be you.
I appreciate you saying so. Speaking of catching fish, you've been catching a mess of them.
Aw, shucks.
Hey, keep it down over there. We're trying to get ready for test run beta.
Well, can't you wait for just a second? A Skinny T is catching a whole bunch of fish. I'm glad somebody is.
Well, I guess I've caught enough for dinner. You know, it's just Ma, Pa, and me.
Yeah.
Whoa, I better get my hook out of the water.
Yeah, I reckon you better. You might want to leave a couple out there for them to test their gizmo.
All right, we'll see y'all later.
That's mighty fine fishing there, young man. Oh, boy. I tell you what, that Skinny T sure is something, but it's just beginner's luck.
All right, it looks like we have conclusive evidence that sea life has returned to the immediate vicinity. Guys, I think it's time for test run beta. We're going to start countdown in T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
La la.
Perfect! Agnes, poor results of test run beta!
Satellite reconnaissance is inconclusive. No aquatic life form movement detected.
What do you mean they ain't moving? The fish out there has got to be moving around, unless...
Todd, what's wrong?
Can't breathe. Ran all the way.
Todd, what is it? Spit it out already. Come on!
Well, all I can say is... Hit it, Maestro.
By the shore now, when I hit something huge and it threw me right off of my board now, I looked all around.
saw something I had not seen before now. Cause there were fish, 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 and I think a Jubilee's underway. So I was choking on the waves and I spitting up a bucket of sand now. There were so many fish I could run on their backs to the land now. I had to tell everybody, so this is the place where I ran now. Cause there were fish, 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 and I think a Jubilee's on his way. Girls cook it up, I know they're gonna need a Texas-sized pan now. So come on everybody and let's grab all the fish that we can now. Cause there were fish, 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 and I think a Jubilee's on the way.
Dudes, wait for me!
I didn't get to fish at all on this day. I trust that God knows better than I do. I spent the whole day wishing God would bless my fishing, but I didn't do a thing I wanted to. I can't come out here and be alone. God, won't you give this old dog a little bone?
Talking to Miss Ida. She said you left so quickly that she didn't even thank you for fixing her pier. Now, why would you do a thing like that?
Self-preservation. It's a natural instinct to run from danger.
Here he is, Miss Ida. As you can see, his attention has been focused on catching General Washington all day long.
If only that was true.
Oh, well, he wants to catch that fish so bad. But I'm going to leave you two alone. See you later.
Wait, don't leave me all alone with...
Bye-bye!